Rachel, and this video is going to show how to use a pouch sling with a newborn. A pouch sling is really cool because it folds up tiny. You can just stuff it in your purse and then you have a quick carrier for whenever you need. It also works well from newborn up through toddler. I'm going to show how to use this with a newborn. The first thing you want to do is find the seam of your pouch. That's where your baby's bottom is going to go. I usually begin by gathering the side opposite the seam into one hand, just loosely like that. You can fold it in half if you prefer. I prefer to just gather it. I find it quicker and easier. Now I'm going to hold it in my right hand to have baby on the left side of my body. I'm holding it in the right hand. My left arm's going to go through and my head will go over. Then once I have it on, I'm going to make sure it is well spread out in the back, not twisted or anything. And I'm going to find my seam and slide it around so it's in the front of my body. If I'm going to have baby on my hip, I'll put it to the side of my body, but since I'm wrapping a newborn in this today, I'm going to keep the seam right in front where my baby's bottom will be. And at this point, I'm ready to pick up baby. Come here, baby. This little guy is about 6 weeks old. I'm going to lift him up on my shoulder like I'm going to burp him. Reach my hand under the sling, grab for his feet, and guide his feet straight down and through. Then I'll take a moment to just position him onto this tube of fabric so that the seam is going to be right at his bottom. I have to slide it a little bit there. All right, I'm going to seat him right on top of it and just get him positioned and seated. So both knees are above his bottom. He's centered in the middle of my body. At this point, I'm ready to find my top edge and spread that out. So I'll find the top edge, bringing that seam right along his spine. There we go, and tuck his little arm in. The next thing I want to do is make a seat with the sling. What a seat means is that the fabric is going from knee to knee on the baby. So there's a few ways to do this. One way I like to do it is put the bottom edge in my hand, like this. Lean forward, push baby's knees slightly up. That's one way. You can also reach under one foot and pull the fabric up between you. And what that does is just makes it go knee to knee in between you. It doesn't have to bubble up in between you. Just make a straight line from knee to knee. And another thing I like to do is pull slack from the back and slide my hand in a straight line over to make a good seat. Alright, the next thing I want to do is tighten because this top part is very loose still and he can really bob his head around a little bit more than I'd like. I can tighten that really quickly by bringing this top edge out over my shoulder. It's called capping the shoulder. I like capping it this direction more with an older baby, with a younger baby. I actually prefer to reach under the shoulder, take the top edge, and pull it out to the edge of my shoulder this way. That shoulder flip looks a bit more like kangaroo carry, and I find that it just gives him a little bit less room to move his head around because of the way the bottom edge goes up toward my neck and kind of holds that in place. So now I'll do a little check, making sure his knees are above his bottom. Lean forward to get a bit, just to get him straightened out in there. There we have super quick and easy carry that works well newborn to toddler.